If you wonder how I make my YouTube thumbnails on Linux, watch this video and you will learn the process. Hello everyone, it's Edge Linux User, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. And in this video, I will show you how I make thumbnails for my YouTube videos. I didn't plan to make this video today, I had another topic in mind. But I've got this comment which says that I stole a thumbnail from another YouTube video. And it was insulting because I spend a lot of time making custom thumbnails for all my videos. So in this video, I would like to show you the process of making a thumbnail, and I will make the same thumbnail you saw when you click on this video. Let's get started! I don't make my thumbnails from scratch every time, I just modify the previous thumbnail. And as you have noticed, all my thumbnails have this style, so I have a screen and some background behind. So I just need to change the central part and change the background. And as you can see here, there are not many layers. The one layer is the frame, as you see it disappeared now. And then I just change these parts, so I can replace the central part with anything I need for my new thumbnail. And then I just replace the background, as you can see here. But in this video, I will show you how to make a thumbnail from scratch, so you can have your own template for your thumbnails. Making a thumbnail is not difficult if you have a good idea of how your thumbnail will look. And in this case, I will make a thumbnail again with the screen as a central feature of the thumbnail. So I go to the website pixabay.com. On this website you can find a lot of material which is free to use. So I search for monitor, and as you can see here there are many options, and usually in the filters I select illustrations. I like this monitor, so let's download it. You can download it in different resolution, I usually select the maximum resolution possible. You can also download it as a vector graphic, but for YouTube you need to pixelated graphic, so there is no point to use vector graphic here. And I think using vector graphic is a bit more complicated, if you're not experienced. So let's download it. And for this thumbnail we will also need YouTube logo and GIMP logo. You can also search for them here in Pixabay. For example, let's search for GIMP. As you can see, here is one illustration. Again, in the filters I select illustrations. And this one looks quite good, as you can see here it's Creative Commons license, so it's free to use. We don't need the maximum resolution here, because we will use it a little bit smaller than we need. So I download this one. And we also need to find YouTube logo image. So I will show you how to find it in Google, because it's a bit different tool. So you type YouTube logo, then you click on image, because we need an image. And in the tools, you can select the usage right. And we need to use labeled for reuse, because you're gonna reuse it. And as you can see here is plenty of choice, so I will just use the first one. So you select save image as, and let's save it to downloads. Now we have all the images we need for this thumbnail. Let's go to the downloads, and here the three images we're gonna use. So you select all the images you're gonna use, and open them in GIMP. So these are the three images we opened, and we're gonna use them in our thumbnail. But first we need to create a template for our thumbnail. You click on New. For YouTube thumbnail the best resolution is 1920x1080. Now we need to process this screen image. What I want to do, I want to remove the central part, which is a black one, because we're gonna replace it with our own graphics. So to do that I usually select this tool, select by color. And here you can define the threshold by which you select different colors. So let's leave it by default. So if you use the default threshold, as you can see, it selects too much. So we need to lower the threshold, let's lower it to 1. Okay, now it selects more or less what we need, but as you can see, it still selects a bit extra. So what we're gonna do now, we need to select free selection tool. And here you have several options. And what we need to do, we need to subtract from the extraction. So we need to remove everything what was selected and we don't want to select it. And it's quite simple here, so you just disable this lower part. As you can see, now selection disappears from here. Then as you can see, we also have some selection on the border here, so we need to disable it too. So now all the unnecessary selections are removed, and we have only the black central part selected which we don't want to use. Next you press the delete key, and the central part is removed. Then you go to select and you press select none. Alternatively, you can press Shift-Ctrl-A. Then you go to Edit and you copy this layer, or you press Ctrl-C. Then we go to our thumbnail, and here you go to Edit and paste it as a new layer. But as you can see, it's a bit too large. Then you select the tool Scale. Here you need to click on this sign so the proportion of your layer are maintained. And let's change it to fit our screen. Let's make it 1000 pixels. Then we move it to the center. You can also put some guidance line. For example, if you move your cursor to this field, you press left button and you start moving, you will get this line. And you can position it somewhere around 1000 pixels, a little bit less. That will be around the center of your screen. And the same you can do from this field. Press your left key here and move down. You can get another guidance line. These lines won't be shown in your picture. They just serve to guide you. And we put it here also around 500 because we know that the height is 1080. So the middle will be here. So this is the center. Now we centered it. And we have our screen, which we will use as a template. Next, let's take this YouTube logo. You copy it with Ctrl-C. And here again, you paste it as a new layer. And you scale it to the size you want. Again, make sure that this sign is clicked and the proportions are maintained. And then you can decrease it. Then we switch to Move tool. And we move this layer as we want. Yeah, this is probably too big. Let's make it smaller. Next, we select our GIMP logo. Again, Ctrl-C to copy it. We go to our screen and here we paste it as a new layer. And we can scale it again as we want. And move it above our YouTube logo. Yeah, it's a bit too big. Let's scale it again. It is also good practice to save your project just at the very beginning when you started to work on it. So you go to File, Save As. So you give it a name and then you press Save. Here you need to spend some time to decide on the size of these logos to find the best combination. I think this size is good. So if after that you can quote these images, we don't need them anymore. And now we work only on this image. So we have the GIMP logo and we have the YouTube logo. Now we need to write that this will be about the thumbnails. You select the text tool and you write thumbnail. Then if you want to increase the font size, you need to press Ctrl-A to select this word and increase its size. Yeah, 120 should be more or less good. And you can also change its font. You can change it directly here or you can go here in the options and change it here. So this sans font is not the most beautiful one, so let's change it to something more attractive. Again, here you need to try different fonts until you find what you like the most. I think this impact font looks quite good. And I also increased the font size a little bit. You can also change its color by clicking on this icon. So I think I will make it with the same color as the eyes of this logo. So you select on this color selection tool and click on the eye. Yeah, I think it looks good. I also want to add some stroke to this text. So you click on the text layer and you go to alpha to selection. The borders of this thumbnail word are selected. Then you change the color here. So I will just put it black. And you go to stroke selection. And here you can define the size of the stroke you want to use in different patterns. Let's try 6 pixels. Yeah, I think it looks good, right? So then you go to select and click select none. Here's our word. Next, what I want to do, I want to rotate it a little bit. So you select rotate tool. And here you can play as you want to rotate it. Yeah, 40 degrees should be good. And then we move it a little bit to fit this image. So this is the thumbnail. I think YouTube logo maybe should be a little smaller. Again, when you select the scale tool, you need to make sure that you also select your YouTube logo here. It's also good to give names to your layers. So let's double click here and write YouTube. This is our GIMP. This is the frame. It is also good to put the frame on very top. And this is the thumbnail, it's clear. So this is the background. So we selected the tool scale, we select YouTube, and we scale it a little bit. Okay, now it looks better. Next, we need to add some color to these backgrounds. So what I'm going to do, I will select the tool fill, but before that, I will copy this layer just to have a backup, because I'm going to work directly with that layer, and if something goes wrong, so I can just restore as it was at the beginning, so I don't need to make many steps back. So I duplicate it and I hide this copy, then I select the layer I want to use. So again, I have selected the fill tool here, and then we can change the colors here. Well, again, you need to play with different colors here to select something what will look nice with all these combinations. But I think something of this color should work good. So I select this tool, click here, and then I fill it. But as you see, everything disappeared because this layer is on the top. So we will move it at the back. Okay, this is how it looks. Again, you can go to the settings and try to play with different colors until you find something that looks very good. Okay, I think this color looks more or less good. Now let's change the background color. And here I like to use the gradient tool, which is this one. To use a gradient, you need to specify two colors which you want to use. So usually you need to just change these two colors. And we're going to use here red, because it's a YouTube. And another color will be black, for example. And then you paint as you want here. Yeah, the black one is probably too dark. You can try different directions here. Okay, this corner is too dark, but you can adjust it by defining the length of this gradient. For example, if you put here, the corner will be completely dark. But if you put this point somewhere further, then the corner will be lighter. As you can see, it's much better here. So let's increase this gradient to something like this. Okay, it's still dark. Let's make it more. Yeah, now gradient looks quite good, I think. And it is also good to press Ctrl S every time you do some changes, so it will save your image. When you press Ctrl S, you can see that image is saved now. And I see from this image that this corner is quite empty, so we can put something there. Let's put a Linux logo here. So I have a couple of logos here. So let's use my channel logo. You open with GIMP, you copy it, and here you paste it as a different layer. We need to move it up front. Scale it and move it to the position where we want to place it, and scale it again. Yeah, it's still too big, I think. Let's make it 200 pixels. Now it's much better. So this is the way I make thumbnails for my YouTube channel. So for the next thumbnail, I can just change the central part and change the background color. I don't need to recreate the frame every time. So when you are happy with your thumbnail, make sure to save it. Again, you press Ctrl S, or you can go here and press save. And then we need to export it. So if you export it the first time, you can just click export or Ctrl E, or you can also hit export S. So you click export, and then you select where you want to export it. You can export it as PNG or JPEG. For YouTube, it doesn't matter much. I use PNG because the quality is a little better with PNG. And you export it. Compression level, you can change it. From my experience in PNG, it doesn't affect the image too much, so you can change it as you want, but I keep it maximum compression. The file will be smaller, so it will load faster. After that, you open your file manager. This is our .xcf file, and this is the thumbnail. This is the PNG image. Double click to open it, and here it is, the new thumbnail. Now you know that making thumbnails on Linux is possible. It's not very easy, but it's not very complicated either. So I hope you found this video useful. Thank you for watching!